time I go to one of these events, you get a chance to meet the fans, you get a chance to talk to the show, talk about the show with the fans. It's just fantastic. I mean, I'm a fan of the show myself, but to meet such a passionate, wonderful, interested and interesting group, it's a real pleasure for me. I think sometimes, you know, when you're kind of doing what you do and you think, oh, is that okay? And then you come here and you get feedback from people who absolutely live, breathe and eat Westeros. And you think, yeah, did okay. I just love these events. And today has been an absolute ball. Well, from the very beginning, you know, I figured that Meryn was going to bite the dust somewhere. And David and Dan, they're pretty classy guys. They phoned me to tell me, Meryn Morghulis, that's your lot, chum. But they said that you'd see a really nasty side to the character and I'd have a great death. I thought I was going to get to kill somebody popular. I thought, you know, I was going to get to kill Bronn or something. And I got the script and I'm reading it and I'm going, oh my God. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. It was awful. I mean, I have three kids at home. If somebody touched one of my children, let me tell you something, it would take that person a lot longer to die than Meryn. Really. So, yeah, they were extraordinarily upsetting scenes to do. And the biggest challenge of my acting career, bar none. In a way, I was so grateful to the boys for giving me this, you know, giving me this opportunity. Because it's what an actor lives for, to get scenes like this. The actual end, when Maisie and I were filming, Maisie is just an incredible young actress. Absolutely incredible. One of the most stunning young actresses I've ever seen. She's absolutely wonderful. We decided, her and I, very, very early, that in this particular scene, we had to go for it. And we went for it. No point. And I had complete trust in her. She had complete trust in me. It was technically very difficult as well because the eyes, we filmed that last scene on my last day, unusually enough. And it was all filmed in order. So the last take was the last take for me. But very early on in the day, my eyes went out. So I had to have prosthetics. And for the last 7 or 8 hours on set, I was completely blind, which was really weird. Blood tubes coming up, blood going down my nose. It was just technically, you know, it was very difficult. Being blind actually really helped me show a vulnerability to that character at that moment in time. So it actually helped. But it was very, very difficult. And I just thank whatever gods are up there that I had Maisie to do it with, because she is stunning, wonderful.
This Meryn kills Syrio.
I'm sorry, calling Syrio popular. I'm sorry. He may be popular with the fans, but I think Meryn was completely.
You know what? I'm going to message Miltos right now and tell him you said that.
Tell the water dancing little git I said hello.
Miltos is very popular.
I'm pretty certain Syrio went at that point. I would be astonished if we saw Syrio again before the final curtain. I don't think Meryn would have left Syrio alive. If, as some fans believe, Syrio became Meryn, well, surely that would have been revealed whenever Meryn died. Surely then he would have appeared, which would have actually been really weird, if Arya saying she just killed Syrio. But no, Syrio, I believe Meryn killed him. Meryn did not disobey Cersei, ever. It was the only redeeming feature I ever found in the character. His fierce loyalty to Cersei Lannister. The only one. It was episode 10. It was the most horrific 2 days. I have three children at home. The fact that the casting in Game of Thrones is so perfect, they couldn't have found three more beautiful angels to beat than the three they found. And the young actresses that were involved, Hattie, Isabel and Bella, were absolutely fantastic. Instinctively, they were wonderful young actresses. They made that scene. Because if they hadn't reacted the way they did, it wouldn't have worked. They were fantastic. What made it worse was that, you know, you can't stay in character. So as soon as he yelled cut, I had to come out and be in again. I couldn't stay in character. But it was the most upset I think I've ever been, ever, in front of a camera, because there were times when I just said, look, I'm just going to the bathroom. I go to the bathroom and I burst into tears. Now, I will promise you when I say that stick did not touch those children once, and I will promise you when I say those kids had a great day, their parents were there. The Game of Thrones set is a very protected and very protective set. you know, everybody is really carefully looked after. But it was horrible to act the role of a man who took pleasure in doing that. It was the most upsetting scene I've ever done. And honestly, I'm really genuinely very proud of everybody involved in that scene that we pulled it off. Everybody who was in that scene, we pulled it off, and I was really pleased about that. George, the genius, Mr. Martin, who created this incredible world, I do believe him and David and Dan would speak on a regular basis. I'm certain of that. They couldn't not. I mean, for example, I get the feeling that when Book 6 comes out, and this is what, for me, is so exciting. This is the first season, season 6, the one they're making at the moment. This is the first season where there is no guide whatsoever. Even when season 5 came out, A Dance with Dragons was out, and, you know, storylines were known. This is the first season where everybody is completely in the dark. As I say, I'm sure David and Dan and George know that perfectly well. But I, for one, as a fan of the show, I'm extraordinarily excited because I have no idea. I like that. I don't actually like spoilers. I don't want the surprise to be spoiled. I don't want my Christmas presents on Christmas Eve. You know, I'm really excited for, look, I'm really looking forward to season 6, completely in the dark, and anything could happen. I can't actually remember or think of a television show that has been in this situation where you have this incredible set of books written by this genius and you have this incredible television series by these geniuses. And there's this excitement over, will the book come out before the TV? You know, I can't remember a TV show like that. And that is the magic of this program. That is the program these boys have created, these boys and girls, excuse me, have created. And it has been such a privilege to be a part of it. I think Game of Thrones is a game changer for television. I really do. I think we're entering a golden age of television with all the new streaming platforms, the way technology is going, the way social media is going. And I have never been so excited to be an actor in television than I am right now. I think we're entering a golden age, and I think Game of Thrones has set a seriously high benchmark. The audition process for season 1, you know, you get seen for maybe 1, maybe 2, maybe 3 roles in the initial castings. I read for Jory Cassell, Ned Stark's right-hand man, who Nikolai very kindly finished off very quickly, and I got Meryn. So I wasn't in it for half of one season. I was in it for 5 seasons. Jamie Seaves, who played Jory Cassell, was perfect as Jory Cassell. He was absolutely perfect. He nailed it. And he did a much better job than I would have done if I'd been cast in that. The casting, in my opinion, just speaking as a fan of the show, is so good that when you see somebody in a role, you couldn't think of anybody else doing it. You couldn't think of anybody else playing that role. So I was very happy with Sir Meryn, and I wouldn't have wanted to be anybody else because they would have done it better.